this is Ashraf. So this is the unboxing video of Crucial's multi-material upgrade 2.0. I just got this thing few minutes ago, about 15 minutes ago, and yeah, 1 year, ordered this thing last year, about November 14, if I remember correctly from the order page there. And after 1 year, it is finally arrived now. I don't have my watch to check on the date right now. And few of those who already ordered the multi-material unit 2.0 already got the unit, especially those who were early in the process of the ordering. And they got it early, and also they got troubles during the printing. So I also going to join in the bandwagon of having a lot of troubles of, well, printing the multi-material thingy, as well as troubleshooting them. Now, unlike the normal multi-material, is that I have this extra unit here. This one is actually the spring steel sheet. One of them is the smooth PEI sheet, and another is the powder coated. Why I got the powder coated is that originally I wanted to have a powder textured spring steel sheet, but then I stumbled into a problem where my Mark II last time, Crucial Mark II printer, had some burn in the terminal of the back connector there. So they have to rush in the, they asked me that if I'm okay with the spring steel sheet, as well as that, the smooth spring steel sheet, as well as the textured PEI sheet, would be shipped separately, which is this, including with the multi-material upgrade kit 2.0. So, the box pretty detailed. It was torn this way, wasn't handled properly, I believe, but I think that would be okay. This is the front side, top side, left, rear, right, and the bottom didn't have anything. First things is the cardboard, gold button. Congratulations on getting the multi-material upgrade 2.0, assembly manual, manual.crucial3d.com, and the packing list. It was, the weight was about 2.6 kilo, 2648 grams, and the date was checked is about I think 8th of November 2018. So this is the supposed to be the tick mark of those who checked the package of my MMU 2.0 over here. And this is, I believe, a sticker, Crucial sticker. Next is the printing handbook of the multi-material, I believe. Yep, on how to handle the unit. Now let's dive right in. This is the electronic, MMU electronic, the selector. USB cable, I believe this USB cable is to update the firmware of this electronic. This is the spool holder base. Pretty much, I thought this thing would be quite thick. It's actually a polycarbonate, vacuum form polycarbonate, very thin. Not that I really mind. This is the motors, a pleasant. Oh yeah, I forgot to mention that my MMU 2.0 kit over here is the upgrade from the MMU 1.0 to 2.0. So the motors and multiplexer that I have is only one instead of supply two. I believe only one that I needed, which is this one embedded with the lead screw here, but I'm not sure about the other two because one of them is with lead screw, but never mind, let's check the other package. This one, I believe this is the MMU1 to MMU2 fastener and plastic parts set. Let's check inside, what do we have? Electronics part, and this one is spool holder. I don't think I really need this spool holder because I have my own spool. And this is the idler body. Another spool holder, 6 or 8 bearing, and this is the tube box, and the plastic has torn apart. That is because this thing is quite heavy, and this plastic metal rods here also quite it may be sharp for the thing inside there. And this is the rubber fit. I believe this might be for the hole pusher or maybe for the spring holder here. Screwdriver, nippers or clippers, and Allen keys, screws, a set of screws, spare screws. This is the electronic, the wires, the zip ties, and orange Teflon tube. This is the longer Teflon tube for each one of the channel, which is 5 colors. And another more of this 608 bearing. There's kind of the plastic bag. A cutter, so this is the pulley body which has the thing. I see. So right now the material upgrade kit from MMU1 to MMU2, basically what's different is actually for upgrade kit is you will be supplied with one motor for the whole multi-material upgrade kit 2.0, is that you will have three separate motors, but the other one motor is that it will have a longer shaft inside here. But for the upgrade from version 1 to version 2 is that this is the shaft and this is the coupler, which is pretty much small. What else is that this is the idler body. I'm not sure about the other things, especially the idler parts, extruder parts, I mean the pulley. This is the pulley body, let me check. In the meantime, I'm going to put everything back together because my printer is at my home. And also, I'm going to make a video out of it as well. USB extra, which is the extruder upgrade to the R3 version. Let me have a closer look for you guys. Though I already printed my own R3 upgrade version, this is the identical with the one that I printed. Only that this one was printed on the textured PEI sheet, PEI surface, and I'm not going to make any adjustment or change into this thing because I already used one of these. As well as this textile sleeve, these textile sleeves are meant for the extruder cable, so that it is much easier for those who are using this thing to make adjustment, because using a spiral rod is quite tedious, where you have to keep on spiraling those spiral rods. And this is the square nuts and bolts for you to fit in the new R3 extruder body. Let's inspect a little bit. I got two of these instead of one because the smooth PEI sheet that I have basically is the earlier version, the early version of the smooth PEI sheet version, which is there's a risk of the spring steel sheet inside there getting rust. So this is the final product, I believe. Yeah, texture, pretty nice. I would like to have a test print on top of this thing and see if I'm getting an improvement of first layer bonding on the surface there. And this one should be the smooth sheet. Yep, this is the smooth version. And also I believe this is the later version, which the spring steel, wow, it's black as well, instead of the first version, which is goldish in color or yellowish. This is slightly yellowish, yellowish. This is slightly yellowish due to the fact that it is the PEI sheet itself, but I believe the spring steel has been coated with something to prevent further rusting. So yeah, this is it about the unboxing video of the multi-material upgrade 2.0 which I just got today. Another video will follow up very soon where I'm going to assemble this thing to fit into my Crucial Mark 3. So don't forget to subscribe to my channel to help my channel grow as well. Do leave a comment if you have any suggestion or any question regarding this thing or any other things. I will try to answer your question. Support my Patreon as well. Ashraf signing out. Peace.